In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a custom settings panel for the websites that you design for your customers. It's going to make your life that much easier. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies. And if you find value in this video, I'd like you to maybe consider clicking on the subscribe button. And if you want video notifications, there's a little bell off to the right of that button. Click on that and YouTube will notify you when I have new videos. So what am I talking about here? I'm talking about making your life easier. You know, a lot of times what happens when you create a website for someone else, or maybe even for yourself, and 6 months or a year has gone by, you don't necessarily remember how to change certain things that you wanted to change. Here's a perfect example. Say you set up a website for someone, or maybe it's for yourself. Let me get back to that. And you have your content on all of these different pages. And say, for instance, you have your phone number in various locations on your website, all throughout the website, and then your phone number changes and you need to update it. But you have it in so many different locations, you really don't know every place that you have that phone number. And the same could be said of business hours, addresses, or any kind of information that is the same, but you're going to use it over and over again in a website. So what I'm going to teach you how to do in this video is create a custom settings page in the back end of WordPress. We can name it whatever we want, and then we'll create these custom fields that we can put this information, and then you'll use a short code everywhere in your content to display it dynamically. And the beauty is, if you ever need to change a phone number, all you have to do is go to that settings panel, change it right there, and it will change in every single location that you put that short code in. And obviously this has a lot more uses as well. Now, this is not page builder specific. It will work with any page builder or WordPress theme that you're using. So let's get started. Now, what we're going to use for this is something called Pods. Pods is a WordPress tool that I'm going to be using on a series of videos, and this probably is the first one. I might have talked about Pods a few times before. It allows you to pretty much extend what you could normally do with WordPress, and it's so crazy simple to use. It's just really an amazing tool. And the best thing about Pods as well is it's open source. There's no cost to it, although they do have a way that you could support them. I am happy to be one of their supporters. I send them money each month to help the development along. Pods is pretty darn amazing. So here I am on a WordPress installation. All you have to do is go to plugins. Now, I've already installed all these plugins because I wanted to save time. So what you would need to install is just Pods right here. Pods, custom content types and fields. Okay, that's the name. Go ahead and install that. Now, later in this tutorial, I'm also going to show you some neat things you could do with Pods if you happen to be using the Beaver Builder page builder. There just happens to be some specific integration that a Beaver Builder user built with it to make some things a little easier. But if you're using a different page builder, it doesn't matter. You're going to be able to use Pods perfectly fine. So what Pods does is it allows us to create custom fields. It allows us to create custom post types, and it also allows us to create these custom settings panels. So in this video, I'm only going to show you the setting panel and the custom field portion of it, but it does so much more, and you really should start getting comfortable doing more with your WordPress website, and Pods is really the tool to do that. So once you've installed Pods on your website, just go ahead and click on it, and then you're going to come to this screen here that says Add New. And what we're going to do is we're going to click right here where it says Create New, because we're going to create this custom settings panel. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that, and first it's going to say the content type. Now what we're going to do is choose this option that says Custom Settings Page. In some other videos, I'm going to talk about custom post types and custom taxonomies, but we don't need to get into that right now. We're just going to get our feet wet using Pods, and we're going to create a custom settings panel. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that. Now, what we need to do is we need to give it a title and a label for the menu. So essentially, I'm going to have this setting page appear over here. It's going to go actually right down here below, and we get to pick a name for that. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to just name both of these business info. Now, you can name it whatever makes sense to you. The first thing I thought was, why don't I name it settings? But we already have a settings, so I'm going to name it business info. Now, you can also place it underneath settings or underneath appearance with this option right here. So by default, it wants to add it to the settings menu, so it would appear in here, but I'm going to go ahead and make it its own menu item by choosing this option right there. So I'm going to go ahead and enter business info for both of these, but you can name it whatever you want. So there it is. I've chosen business info for the page title and for the menu label. I'm going to go ahead and click on next step, and it's going to go ahead and create this for me, and it's going to take me to an area where I can start creating these custom fields. Now first, before I create my custom fields, you can see right there underneath the settings, we have it listed right there, business info. Now you can move this up higher if you wanted, and we can change this icon. So what we would do there is we would click on admin UI right there, and here's where we can manipulate the position of where it is on this list, and here's where we can choose a different menu icon. So let's go ahead and choose a cool menu icon. So this is linked up with dash icons, and I could put a link down this below. I'm actually surprised there's no link in here for it, but that's okay. I'll put a link down below, and we can choose any of these icons that we want. So let's go ahead and pick something that we think is cool. This is like settings right here, or maybe this home. Why don't I choose the home like that? So I'm gonna, actually that might already be used in WordPress. I'm gonna go ahead and use this right here. Okay, so I click on it, and all I need to do is highlight right here and put this into my clipboard. Okay, then it's in my clipboard. I just need to go right here to menu icon and then paste that in like that. Now when I click on save pod, this icon should change as soon as the page refreshes, and it is refreshing right now, and there it is. Now we have that cooler icon. If this is a website you're delivering to your customers, I'd also recommend changing the location here, the menu order, and putting it up. Oh, actually, we're using that same icon up here. That's okay. You get the idea. So I'm going to go ahead and create a custom field right now. All we have to do is click on add field. Now, I would suggest maybe just creating a series of fields there. In this example, maybe business name, business address, maybe business phone number, fax number, or business hours, or anything like that that you think your customer or you might want to change, but have a real easy way of doing that. And another perfect example of a good use case scenario for what we're doing in this tutorial is those, if you're selling websites to people and you're starting off of a template. So say you build it all out, you put the copy in there, but all you need to change on these websites is just these personal bits of information, the business name, the phone number, the business hours, things like that. You can actually use this to crank out websites in no time because you're just changing it in one location. So for a custom field, all we have to do really is three things. We need to give it a label, and then this name right here is going to automatically populate. And then we need to choose the field type right here. So all of the field types I'm going to do in this video are going to be just the plain text, but there's different field types. So here'd be the website, a phone number, an email address. Now the difference between the phone field type and the plain text is if you choose phone, it will only accept a properly formatted phone number. So you have that ability to make sure what goes in is the right thing. Same thing goes for email addresses. And we have these other different custom fields that I will be going into more detail in other tutorial videos. So I'm going to leave it at plain text. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create two fields. I'm going to create a business name, and I am going to create a phone number field. Okay, I've already created the business name field and I've filled out the information here for business phone. I'm going to choose the phone field type. Now what happens is right after you put a label in and then you click out of this field, it's automatically going to populate this right here where it says name, because it needs to be a certain format. Everything needs to be lowercase and there needs to be an underscore instead of spaces. And we will actually be using this little bit of information when we go to actually display it. So you can see the same thing happen right here for business name. I entered business name and then it automatically formatted it like that for me. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and click on add field right here. And there we go. I have my two fields. Very easy. I'm going to go ahead and click on save pod. And as soon as this gets saved, I'm going to go ahead and click in the business info and we'll put some information in there. So I'm going to click on business info right now. And you're going to see we have those two custom fields. Now you could make this be as extensive as you want. In fact, you can actually create an entire homepage where you're using the information that someone can input right here and it will automatically populate on the front page. So I'm going to go ahead and put some information in here right now. Okay, so I've already gone ahead and put a business name and a business phone. I'm going to click on save changes. And so now that information is going to be in there. So now what we need to do is generate the short code that you're going to place all throughout your website to display the value in each of these fields. And it's actually very easy to do. So I'm going to go to pages and let's go ahead and add a new page. And I'm not going to style it or anything like that. I'm just showing you how this works in this video. So I'm going to go ahead and put a title in here. Okay, I put homepage in there. And what we need to do is generate this short code. And then we're going to be able to copy and paste it wherever we want. So I'm going to go ahead and click on pods a short code. And it gives us all of these options here. But what we're going to choose is this option here that says display a field from a single pod item. So go ahead and click on that. And right here, you can choose all of your pods. We only created one pod, and that is the business info pod. So let's go ahead and click on that. And then right here is where you would take that name for the field. So for business name, what it did is it made it all lowercase and it replaced any spaces with an underscore. Now you can go back to the pods area to get that name, but I already know what it is. So I'm going to go ahead and enter it now. So go ahead and put that in. I've entered the business name. I'm going to click on insert. And this actually happened to me. And I'm going to show you how to deal with it. It's basically saying we need to put something in for ID or slug. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK. And I'm going to paste the same thing in right here, the same business name, and go ahead and click on insert. And so what this is going to do is it's going to generate this entire short code here that you can use over and over. But I'm going to let you know, you could actually, where it says slug in this business name, you can get rid of this if you didn't want that there. And so now we know the format. So for the business phone number, we're going to just use this same format. The name is business info and the specific field we want to display is business phone. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this into the clipboard. And then I'm going to go here, I'm going to paste it in and I'm going to change this from name to phone, which is the name of the other field. So I'm going to go ahead and click on publish now, and I'm going to show you what it shows on the front end of the website. You can see it is showing it perfectly. Here's my business name and here is that phone number. Now what you could do is you could take these short codes and anywhere you're going to show the business phone number, you could put that short code in instead. So that way in the future, if the business owner or your customer or you want an easy way to change that little bit of information anywhere on the website, this is how you would be able to do this. Think about it, just creating a templated website with proper paragraphs and copy in there, and you have it all short code based so you can duplicate that for a customer and just change a couple fields and the website is ready to go. It's pretty amazing what you're able to do. So that is going to pretty much work in any page builder. You could take this short code and it will work in any page builder. It'll work in Elementor, it'll work in Beaver Builder, it'll work in Divi, it'll work in any different page builder that you might be using. So right now I'm going to show you how easy it is to do this with Beaver Builder and Beaver Themer. So I'm going to go ahead and click on, actually you don't need Beaver Themer. Anyways, I'm going to go ahead and click on Page Builder right here, and it's going to open up in Beaver Builder 2.0, which I have installed. So I actually haven't gotten into it yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the plus, and I'm going to say choose the, I'm going to go ahead and choose the heading. So I'm going to drop a heading right there, and it's going to pull this up. So instead of generating that short code, all I have to do is click on this little plus, scroll all the way down, and we have these options for pods. Now what we want to do is display one of these settings fields. So I'm going to go ahead and click on connect, and then I'm going to choose the setting field that I want. And so it knows the only setting panel I created was that business info one. And so it shows me all the available fields. I'm going to go ahead and click on business name. I'm going to go ahead and click on save. And then I'm going to go ahead and click on save again. And there it is. It's a little easier using Beaver Builder because of this add-on that is available for pods and for Beaver Builder. Let me go ahead and click on done and click on publish. And then I'm going to go ahead and, just in case, I want to show you the name of that add-on. Go to plugins. It is Pods Beaver Themer add-on. Now Pods and this add-on right here are available in the WordPress repository. You could just go to plugins, add new, and you'll see them all right there. So anyways, in this video, I just wanted to show you how simple it is to create these custom professional settings panels that you can put information in and display them wherever you want dynamically on your website. Now, in future videos, I'm going to show you how to create custom post types, custom fields for those custom post types to display the content in those custom post types. And I'm also going to show you how to link custom post types together. You could do so much with pods. It is a very amazing add-on plugin that you can get for WordPress. There are a ton of very creative uses for it that will allow you to do more with your WordPress-based websites. So if you have any specific questions about pods that you'd like me to cover in one of these videos, go ahead and please leave it in the comments down below. Or if you have any creative ideas that you'd like to share with the community here that you can use this custom settings panel for, I'd love it if you'd contribute and enter a comment down below. I'd love to hear your ideas of how this could be leveraged. As usual, I have links to everything down below, to pods, their website, Beaver Builder, Elementor, my website. I'll also put a link down below to that. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video on pods.